Last month, the world's top climate scientists delivered a sobering warning. Their mammoth report to the UN boiled down to one message: act now before the climate breakdown becomes unstoppable. The report says extreme weather has forced millions of people from their homes and devastated food supplies. Oil and gas emissions are at a record high. The UN report calls for drastic cuts in fossil fuels. But if our old technologies got us into this mess, can new ones get us out? Among politicians, corporations, and billionaires, one new technology is gaining traction. It's called direct air capture, that vacuums carbon dioxide out of thin air and locks it away underground. Sound like science fiction? We thought so too, until we went to Iceland to see the world's first commercial direct air capture plant in operation. Here, on a frigid plain near the Arctic Circle, worries about an overheating planet seem far away. Yet tiny Iceland has put itself on the front line with a new kind of machine that will fight climate change by sucking carbon dioxide out of the air. This is Orca, the first commercial direct air capture plant on Earth.
What are these fans? How does this work?
Here you see the backside of these collectors, where the air is being pulled through the system by aid of these fans.
Carlos Hertel is chief technology officer for Climeworks, the Swiss company that built Orca. He told us as the fans draw air in, the carbon dioxide is trapped by a special filter inside these giant collectors, each the size of a shipping container. The captured CO2 is then siphoned off to storage tanks. We had to shout over the powerful fans as a bitter wind whipped around us.
So you didn't come for this wonderful weather?
No, we did not. We knew that the windows were harsh, but it's a good real-life test as well for the plant.
What you're describing almost sounds like science fiction, but what you're saying is that we can actually do this.
People never doubted the fundamental physics or chemistry of it, but realizing it under real-life conditions is a whole different matter. And that's what this system shows. It can be done.
Climeworks is now building a new plant in Iceland 10 times the size of Orca that will look like this, a modular design that Hertel told us can be easily assembled. But capturing the CO2 is only half of the story.
So this is where the magic happens.
The second half starts here in these metal igloos, where the CO2 is sent to be buried in the porous volcanic rock of Iceland.
So this pipe is actually filled with water.
Sandra Ösk is a geologist with CarbFix, an Icelandic company that pioneered the groundbreaking injection method.
Here we have the CO2, and the CO2 is actually dissolved in water, so it's actually just fizzy water.
Just fizzy water.
Yeah, and this fizzy water is being injected here into the injection well.
How far down does it go?
It actually reaches over a mile down.
A mile down?
Yeah.
The fizzy water is shot like a soda stream into Iceland's basaltic rock, where it reacts with the minerals and hardens to stone in less than 2 years.
So the fizzy water turns into this.
Yes.
Just a matter of years.
So you take this gas that you can't see, you turn it into fizzy water, and then it turns to stone, and you don't have to worry about it.
Turned into stone. It's quite amazing.
CarbFix didn't invent the process, nature did. But nature takes millennia. After years of experimenting in Iceland's grueling outdoor laboratory, CarbFix figured out how to speed things up. Aerospace engineer Carlos Hertel told us Orca was a milestone. Now the hard part starts, scaling up fast enough to slow climate change.
Whether we are taking the right direction will depend as much on societal things than on technical matters. Am I optimistic as an engineer? I am, absolutely. Am I optimistic as a citizen? Maybe half-half. I haven't made up my mind yet.
This goal can be reached technically. It's just whether we have the political and social will to do it.
I think that's the exact right way of looking at it.